Fire tragedy. A man dies as a house in Melbourne goes up in flames. We have an update live from the scene.
Derailment drama. Another major setback for Queensland's next generation of trains as a test engine comes off the tracks.
The end of an era. Australia's last ever Holden Commodore rolls off the production line. We're live from the Elizabeth factory as workers say their final farewells.
A month's worth of rain in a single day. Sydney's record dry spell finally coming to an end. We have your essential forecast.
A royal engagement. Tea with the Queen.
Ooh.
New details on Meghan Markle's astonishing date at the palace.
It's huge, it's massive, it's $60,000. Get your phones ready, keep watching for your chance to scoop a Friday fortune.
And boys to men, back. The 90s mega superstars join us live with some incredible news. Pump it up, people. It's a Today Show World exclusive.
Go on, take it away.
It's so natural. You belong to
me.
Yeah,
the rule.
I belong to you.
I can't let go, I can't let go. Welcome, folks. What a day it is going to be today.
Yes.
It's Friday, the 20th of October, 2017, and I'm excited.
I'm excited too. We've got a royal engagement on the way. It's all happening.
It's tea a big
with
royal
the
engagement.
Queen. Mm. My goodness me.
Mixed with boys to men, a man who is very excited, more excited than I am, Timmy Gilbert.
Mm.
Yeah, I know. I thought I'd come to the end of the road with Boys to Men back at Hits and Memories 2GN in the early 90s, but here we go again.
They're back, bigger and better than ever.
Yeah, they are. Caulfield Cup Day tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Look, it's a big weekend of sport. We're going to talk about that this morning.
Sweet stuff. Looking forward to it, Timmy. And a little bit of end of the road from you later on, too. Just feel it, bro.
Wouldn't
just
that
let
be bad.
Find the romance.
And a very happy good morning to Aislin, who's with us this morning.
Good morning. Hi, great nice to be to here. You. Happy Friday. Bit of a flashback Friday with Boys to Men.
Yeah, hello.
How's that
hello.
Gorgeous little girl of yours going?
She's really good. Almost one now.
Oh.
Yeah, almost walking.
She's
lots
practically
of fun.
In the clubs.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's don't all coming that. Up a little bit later in the program, but let's get the news kicked off now.
Thank you very much. And we will begin this morning with tragic news out of Melbourne, where a man has been found dead after a blaze at Camberwell in the city's east. We'll go live now to Today Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn, who's first on the scene for us. Chris, there's an investigation underway there now. Awful Aislin. News. Christina Hearn, thank you very much.
To Queensland now, where an investigation is underway after a brand new train came off its tracks in Ipswich. Live to Today Queensland reporter Jess Millward, who's at the maintenance yard for us. Jess, it's not a good look for the troubled new fleet of trains. It sounds like those trains are moving near you. Jess, thank you for that. We'll talk to you very soon. Deb.
A teenager has been stabbed in the leg during a robbery involving a large gang in Sydney's West overnight. The 19-year-old man was knifed four times after a group of 10 men demanded cash from him and his four teenage friends. He was treated at the scene in Bosley Park before being taken to hospital in a stable condition. Police are still hunting the gang, who ran off with phones, cash and other personal items. A man who sat on the roof of a Sydney high-rise in a 12-hour standoff with police is expected to be charged with murder today over the death of his ex-partner. The body of the 34-year-old woman was found on the ground below the Chatswood apartment block last week. Police will allege she was pushed by her partner, a 37-year-old Korean national. He then climbed onto the awning of the 26th floor, with police negotiators eventually coaxing him down.
Let's take a look at the markets now. And on Wall Street, the Dow Jones is lower this morning, so is the S&P 500. And oil is down at the moment, while the Australian dollar is buying...
Oh.
Wait for it. It's higher against most of the majors this morning, buying almost 79 US cents.
Now, check this out. A brave police officer has done the unthinkable, reaching into the murky waters to grab a baby alligator, which had been terrorising students at a Florida high school. The police department decided against calling a trained alligator trapper because, you know, why do you need to? Because this officer took on the task with just a pair of gloves to protect his hands. And apparently he does fancy himself, this policeman, as a bit of a real-life crocodile hunter, Steve Irwin-ish, and he leapt at the chance.
It's like one of those little baby lizards.
he needs the music to make it look impressive.
Oh, I liked it.
No, the little ones still have sharp teeth.
They have
teeth.
Very sharp teeth.
It doesn't
like little
matter
puppies.
How small the teeth are.
Garbage.
They still can be sharp.
Garbage, Aislin.
That's just a tiny little lizard.
That's just like taking a cat off the back.
Whatever.
I've got a toddler with very little teeth, and I can tell you they're sharp.
You can attest to that.
They're sharp.
Yeah. Toddlers are very different to handle.
Sometimes.
Well, Timmy Gilbert is ready and raring to go. Look at him perched on the edge of his desk this morning. Timmy, good morning.
Wear a glove. Good with a pair of tweezers.
Yeah.
Coming up, Gary's back. The dual Brownlow medalist speaks for the first time following his trade back to Geelong. And what will happen to Ange Postecoglou? He finally talks about his future as Socceroos coach. It's on the way.
We're giving away a Friday fortune. $60,000 is on the line. It's a huge cash call.
And with just 365 days to go until the Invictus Games, we've got a huge announcement coming up. Plus news of a very royal engagement. It's coming up on the show.
Welcome back to Today. These are our top stories. This Friday morning, Australian teacher Gabrielle Maynor has been shot dead in Kenya during a robbery in broad daylight on a city street. In Melbourne, a 25-year-old man has died in a house fire this morning in Camberwell in the city's east. A sad day in Adelaide, where The Last Holden is rolling off the production line, marking the end of car manufacturing in Australia. And Sydney is getting a good soaking this morning. The first decent rainfall in 76 days, bringing the city's record dry spell to an end.
That's a live shot there of the harbour.
Very gloomy
very
skies there.
Very grey around the gills.
So it was Dickie this morning. Dickie, are you okay?
I'm well, Carl.
You know what? You're on the up. Now, if you've ever wanted a day with Dickie, and look, let's face it, plenty have. You may want to take a sneak peek behind the scenes here at the Today Show. Our Dickie can be very demanding, as our producer Yana finds out every single bloody morning.
Call number one.
Wow.
Stitcher.
Number three. This is my fourth one, but you did a good job, phone call.
Still got it.
You know, the magic doesn't happen by accident,
exactly.
Carl.
As you always say, Dickie.
We always say that, don't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, well done.
Anyway, Yana, thank you for a good week. She's got next week off and stress leave.
And thank you to all of our behind-the-scenes people.
They
do a
tremendous
job making this happen every day.
Sarah gets about 30 calls a day.
Yeah. Well, we couldn't do it without you, all of our behind-the-scenes people. Well, we could do without Brett, who's on camera too.
And we go out of focus. Are we going to go out of focus?
He hasn't been in focus since 86.
Don't stand there.
It's about time. I love you, Brett. I love you. I love you.
All right. I thought his name was Bruce.
Jim, I love you. All right, coming up in our next hour, do you have the magic touch?
Brett does.
I do. The telltale signs you can be a psychic without even knowing it, Deb.
Plus, get ready to laugh. One of Australia's best love comedians, the hilarious Akmal Saleh, is taking over the studio.
Also ahead, a month's worth of rain in a single day. Yes. Sydney's record dry spell finally comes to an end. We have everything you need to know. Your essential forecast is coming up next.
Yes, and also on this Carve Up Friday, we have your first look at the fabulous Margot Robbie as Tonya Harding in the movie I, Tonya. Happy Friday, Australia. Thank you for your company and have a great weekend.
Oh, yeah, well said.